We have a base for calibration. We have a base for regulation. I'm sure you've heard of regulatory agencies before, not so? In your universities, you had regulators. You have regulators in your department. Your head of department is your major regulator. And he uses other staff to regulate you. Generally, you have a regulator on examination. You have a regulator on registration. You have a regulator on this. You have a regulator on that, on that. So nobody can just come and just do whatever he likes. You understand? You can just do what you like. Next. So, you could see, I was saying now, you can't just do what you like. There are boundaries. Boundaries. Heard of boundaries, Naso? Heard of boundaries? In fact, I'm a Yoruba man. We have a joke in Yoruba that you and your father, when you have some things, there must be boundaries. You, as children in that home, and your parents, you own everything together in that home. Not so, but you are not, your mother is not your wife. It is your father's wife. Your father is not your husband. It's your mother's husband. Even in the home, you own everything together, but there are boundaries. And by the time we finish now, I want us to start applying these things. I'm sure your head is already thinking. It's true. That's how I do my integration. I integrate from one to two. Oh, I integrate from this to this. If I'm doing integration, I can tell you length. Whether it is height, whether it's depth, I didn't tell you. I must tell you. If I tell you that a ball travels a particular distance, I didn't tell you whether it started from up. I didn't tell you whether it started from down. Because that's what will give you an idea whether that equation which you have written is minus or plus. Anyway, so you could see that what I'm saying generally now, they are already established in all every other thing that we do in engineering. And I'm going to prove to you today that potentially engineers are the best potential managers. Engineers are potentially the best managers. Because everything that you do in management, we already did it in class. Only your teacher did not tell you. All this is what I've said. Don't you do your mathematics? All the things I've said, just wait. Close your eyes. Think about all that I've said right now. Are they new? I'm saying it, and it seems as if they are new to you. They are not new. But I'm sure you have not been looking at it this way I'm discussing with you. You knew them, you didn't know you know. You understand? You knew all these things, but you didn't know that you knew. And that's what's happening. By the time I finish today, you see that I would have taught you nothing new, nothing new, nothing new. All I'm doing is that if you have a dilute solution and you make it into crystals, that's all I'm doing today. So, next. Once we've done this, we are now ready wrote an article, you can now say this or that or that. You articulate. You build a system. You build a system and you give it a structure. I overheard your leader to you now. You know, as he was talking to you, I was telling myself, told you a simple thing which comes to your mind when they say differentiation. I'm sure many of us differentiate in this class, but you have only not been differentiating mechanically, tell me. You just do differentiation mechanically. So I want you to start looking at differentiation now in an organic form with meaning. You can break it down. Different areas. You have academic areas. You have the non-academic. Then you have other services like health services, security services, and so on and so forth. In the academic area, you have faculties, you have departments, you have sections or departments, not specialized groups in department. No, so? And so what I'm doing with you today is just, I want you to go back and sit down and see that all these things you have been doing are in this form which I'm then discussing with you. So if you are made now, you are boss here, and they say you're the head of this place, what do? You quickly run through what I just told you now. You know, you have to measure. You have to have units. You have to quickly do all these kind of things. And you have to have a reference. Once you have a reference, there's order. You can, you know. Then, if you have a reference, you have to have a police to make sure that that reference, that standard, is okay. So, nobody has to tell you that you need something like a police. You have to call, don't have to call it a policeman. But you need it. In your house, all these kind of things. You can look at it and say, Daddy, Kai, this is missing here. Say, Daddy, do you know? Because you went through this system. You will now know whether you have a police or you don't have a police now. You even know whether you have reference or you don't have a reference. Whether anybody just does anything the way you want. You just do it the way you want. You come, you do it the way you want. You come, you do it the way you want. You come, you do it the way you want. Is that how life is? It cannot be. There is order. I consider that's what you have said now. Let's now have examples. Let's go to the next. Aha. I'm sorry. I hope I'm not burning your mind. We now come into the usual thing that we do. How many of you have heard of Pareto principle before? Principle. What Pareto says is somebody, management. So, they say they want to teach you management. I tell you, henceforth, if anybody says he's teaching you management, he's just recapitulating what you already knew and giving it another name. Pareto principle says that if you identify 20% of the most important things, 20% of the most important things, and you deal with them, that you have already dealt with all the things that you need to do in that organization. For example, once in a particular class, what do you want to do? What does the teacher want to do? He wants to find out who is the head of that noise. And when you remove him, that's all. If law and order breaks down in a university, what do? You remove the VC. Remove the VC and replace him. That's all. That's all. And you bring the other person. You don't remove any student. You just remove the VC. You don't even remove the DVCs. Let's now see how do we differentiate? How do we differentiate? See, this is the way we differentiate. We say there is an equation, there is a model. You know, we set up a model. There is an equation. I say it's too big, I can't understand it. So you want to differentiate. You want to differentiate with respect to the one variable, just one variable. You can differentiate with respect to other variable, other variable, other variable, keeping the other variables constant. And when you finish with that, the one you are varying before, you also keep it constant. In those days, we didn't have enough memory in our mind to be able to keep those. That's why we couldn't do a lot of things there. But now, you can keep this result in one cell, keep that result in another cell, keep that result in another cell, and now form another model and differentiate that model again. And life becomes so simple. Now, it's possible. So what are we doing? What are we doing? We say that y is equal to x to something. Let me give you an example. That x, suppose that x was 2 and that n was 3. As it is now, 2 to n. What would that be? 8. But suppose we remove that x, n, and put it on the right hand side, on the left hand side. We call it a coefficient, no so? 2 multiplied by 3, 6. So it means when you put that index, you put it on top, it is more powerful than when it's on the other side. So we say it is 2 to the power 3. When it's on this side, we do not say it's to the, because it has less power. So you could see that even those people, they understood these things, that powerful than when it is somewhere. If we pick one of you now, I will make you head of this thing. It becomes more powerful than the rest of you. When he says keep quiet, you all keep quiet. When he says rise, all of you will rise. Okay? So you could see I'm doing examples from what you already know. And somebody now calls that subject management. Is it management? You don't know the principle. And somebody you put in one class say is going to teach you how to manage, which you are already managing on your paper. Don't you see that it's we ourselves that are cheating ourselves? We are potentially the best managers. Potentially we're the best managers. Because we do it. And from today, I want to excite you. I want to excite you, okay? I want to, who took note of those olden days, these advertisements on PIC? It's in you, it's in you. I want to show you today that it's in you. Bring it out. In you. So when you are doing this, you're already doing the Pareto, using the Pareto principle. And you know, I went further to integrate, and I went, and you see that all those ideas of bringing in, I didn't put it there, boundaries. You have to give the boundary. You have to show whether it's this direction, you have to show that direction. We don't understand each other. Next. Okay. We can stop here. I could give you other examples. Who was here last year? I also gave a lecture like this last year. And I gave you an example of how to apply BODMAS to your life. Which class did you learn BODMAS? Primary. Okay. How did you learn it? The teacher just came to class. Children, today we are going to learn word mass. Then he write VODMAS. All he's saying that is the word mass brackets. If you want, this one bracket. This another bracket. This is another bracket. This is another bracket. And I can say, okay, make all these chairs and we become only one bracket. You cannot subtract or add things that are not alike. You cannot subtract dissimilar things. You cannot add dissimilar things. You cannot subtract goat from sheep. You cannot sheep from goat. But you can sell goats, use the money to buy sheep, and you add the sheep. You can sell the sheep, sell the goats, and combine the money. That's what you are doing. That's your off. So, I'll show you how to use it in life now. If this guy and that guy are quarreling, I call you and say, what's the problem? Say, he has done so, he has done so. Then I say, has he ever done you any good? Just one good, one. He say, yes. Okay. I go to him. Has he ever done you any good? He say, yes. Then after that one, I say, another one. Then I say, why don't you just forget that bad? And I bring it together. You could say I've done bad mass. So, what I'm just saying is that you have so many things inside you. You have so much deposited in you. And it's up to you. It's up to you, not up to me. Up to you, up to you, up to you to apply what is inside you. Have I made a point? Thank you very much.
Let's put our hands together from the floor. Thank you, Doctor. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to introduce to us a past chairman of Zaria Branch, a designer, a mechanical engineer by profession. He works in the automotive design agency, including the filming by himself. So let's put our hands together for engineer A.A. and ladies and gentlemen, we have in the house an ESCO member, a dynamic one of that, the one that his name used to write way again, engineering. When you talk about Kino Nita, but his name is Kino. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for engineer Adeniran Igitoli, also known as KLM. You're welcome, sir. Please keep clapping, keep clapping, keep clapping, keep clapping. So, that is what I said earlier is correct. You are probably correct me. That ladies first, after men, before the children. You know what I'm saying? Ladies first, but after men, before the children. So you see, today, let me also inform you, our national expo didn't just come. But you are speaking, right now as we are all here, you are being here like the world. He took us to the world. I want you to look around, you are seeing the camera right now. Can you see me being recorded? Some of us cannot see. Some can see without no eyes. We have eyes and we can see. So why are you not using it? If I release that album, are you sure they will know it? So that, gentlemen, on a serious note, we have been streamlined right now. We have been watched everywhere in the world. We are on the internet right now. Courtesy, our engineer in Detroit, Kino Mandela. Please put your hands together for him. We have shown you how important you could be, but only if you will step into their shoes. And today he has come to speak to us on a topic that will take you to the next level. I don't like saying the topic, so that I prefer him to say it himself. Ladies and gentlemen, let's put our hands together for our dear engineer when he comes to give us his topic. Please keep clapping, keep clapping.
Permit me to recognize the two great and wonderful engineers on the top table. I want to say that two of them are my great mentors. I'll start with the distinguished professor, the national chairman of chemical engineers. That is engineer professor Adif Pula. Thank you so much, sir. If I continue to talk more about him, perhaps I will even lose count about what I want to say. And this other gentleman that I want to introduce, when he was featuring as the chief examiner of the Nigerian Institute of Engineers, I was nowhere to be found. But destiny took me to Zaria 1 year, and I met with him in his office. And most especially to this same man who introduced me, who was the chairman of Zaria branch then. But through his vice chairman, I was taken to his office. For what purpose? I mean, for what purpose? Just to go and supervise the same examination that I was examining many years back. So I became just a supervisor. I visited him. From that day, I said, this is a wonderful mentor. I became his mentee. I want to introduce my own oga, engineer Dr. Abdullahi Ayinde FLSE. Welcome, sir. And permit me to say one word about the man that introduced me, a former chairman of Zaria branch of the Nigerian Institute of Engineers. I met him and I knew I've met with a talent, with a future leader, with someone who is passionate, committed, and dedicated to the ideas of this great and wonderful society. I want to appreciate, he is the team leader of when you hear Team KLM, that's the team leader, engineer of Sazo, welcome. I recognize the presence of all the engineers here present. And I want to single out the younger ones, the future leaders, the younger generation, our tomorrow. Please, let us be patient. And excuse me, if you know you want to make calls, please go out. I want us to listen attentively to this man who is a political mechanical business engineer. I want us to know that being a professional engineer is not enough. Diversify to become a leader of tomorrow. That is why the topic of today will go into what we call entrepreneurship, creative entrepreneurship. Though that is the topic I was given. But along the line, you see that I want to maneuver my way and diversify a little bit. So that your tomorrow, you remember this young boy standing before you. Because you need to create an identity. I created an identity for myself. And that is the same way I want you to be. If you want to take the path of our gas, the lecture line, know you are taking that path, please. If you want to take the path of some who are either on the lecture line or on the other line, take that path. And if you want to be a political engineer, please. The world is changing. And if you keep on changing, I hate doing things in conventional way. Some people, you see that they remain stagnant. The way it was 20 years ago, they want you to be this year. I refuse that. You have to be a creative and an innovative engineer in this world we are. Things have changed. It was analog. Today it is digital. It was just telling you how we are streamlining. Yes, that is my passion. That is what we have been doing since 2015. And this streamlining we are doing it free of charge for the Nigerian Institute of Engineers. You need to make service. You need to be service oriented. Everything is not about money. Please create a name. On that note, I want to start. Please, first slide. That engineers are technically skilled professionals who are responsible for solving problems. Yes, we know we are problem solvers, but we put it on our lips. You see an engineer who is supposed to solve problems, he is even the one that will be a complainant. I don't know if some engineers work with public complaint commission, that they keep on complaining and complaining and complaining. If this microphone is not working, I better...
Creative, because if you want to be a problem solver, you must be creative. You can't tell me you want to be a problem solver, but you are not creative. It's not possible. You want to be a copycat? So, because my mentors are here now, I just have to do things the same way they were doing it. No, I will follow their footsteps, but what I need to do is to be creative, is to build on what they have taught me. Because if you are telling me you want to behave the way your mentors behave, that means you still be in the era of using typewriter. But we have moved beyond that. After that one, we have moved to the to electronic typewriter. We have moved to a desktop. We have moved to laptop. Now see what we are using now. See what we are using. Though I'm not talking about those of you who only pink. You ping on Facebook, you ping on WhatsApp. Even if they want to ping on Facebook, they will say they have problems. They have challenges. They don't know what they are doing. I'm not talking about those ones. I'm talking of the problem solvers, the professionals who are ready to solve problems. The main focus is on making things work efficiently and effectively by applying the theories and principles of sciences and mathematics to research and develop economic solutions to technical problems. let me tell you, not until you take X plus Y equals to so and so before you talk on technical issues. Not until you take, what's it called, you go to classroom before you talk on technical issues. I just said it. Create an identity for yourself. Make sure you have a technical problem to solve on a daily basis. Make sure you have a technical. Somebody invented AutoCAD. What were we using? Everybody was carrying blackboard or what is it called? Drawing board all around the campus. But today somebody invented it. We can do better in this country. But the problem is we are too busy with rumor making. Rumor research. Most of engineers, when they post something on Facebook, it will be the one that will share. He doesn't even read. He didn't even know what they are posted. He will just share. You think you are technically inclined? No, that is not what you are talking about. Next slide. The purpose of engineering is to innovate, is to design, is to create, and to maintain products, systems, and equipment for the benefit and well-being of humans. Their works are the please no before then. Engineers are the backbone of a nation building. If you agree, wave your hands. But if we are we really taking our rightful position? Why? Everybody will keep on blaming government. I know if I ask you now, you blame government. But we are the problems of ourselves. We refuse. You know the reason. Not until we know the right thing to do, we will continue to blame government for whatever is our problem. Even somebody whose wife is not pregnant will blame government. Somebody whose wife is not doing exercise. Maybe the doctor said, wife, you need to do exercise. We still blame government. Okay, now. With the undergoing reformation and the growing economy, construction patterns have expanded and demanded has increased. To build a nation is to make it habitable for citizens by providing social amenities, fine, yes, security, infrastructure facilities, job creation, food security, and many more as well, as ensure safety and stability against hazards, fine. Those are the basic amenities the government needs to provide for us. But if government refuses to provide for you, what do you need to do? Since you have not been enjoying all these benefits, are you not living? Are you not living? You are alive today. Being born with silver spoon does not make you a rich man. Being born with a golden spoon does not make a rich person. It depends on who you want to be. You choose. Success is not compulsory and it's not automatic. You have to choose. Some people have decided to remain who they are. So shall they stay. But if you want to make it, you need to make a move. Now, next slide. If you look at what is happening in this country today, we have stories of collapsed buildings, stories of so many hazards going on. But most importantly, what I want you to know here is most of these hazards are not being caused by engineers, but the engineers take the blame. Because when a quark is involved in a design or in any infrastructure, an engineer will be blamed. And that is normal, because they are taking over our jobs, our assignments, our duties. That is why there are problems all over. And that is why the Nigerian Institute of Engineers keep advocating for our engineers will be rightly positioned. We have done so many. We have gone around to ministries and agencies. Even we have gone around to the power brokers of this country that we need to be rightly positioned. But it is not to be left with only the leadership of the Nigerian set of engineers. In the course of this paper, you will understand more about that. We are blessed with abundant natural resources. Yet, we do not ask why they are not competing in the international market. I think if I ask that question, why are we not to the standard? we keep on believing that we are a developing nation. That is even on paper. Are we even developing? We are underdeveloped. Because we have underdeveloped, we have developing, we have developed. Maybe I was telling somebody, maybe you were too eager to get independent. I don't think in 1960, when Nigeria became independent, that we even were matured enough. Because I don't know, it's just like a little boy who wants to jump in a day. You have to start due process. You have to know what to do. But Nigeria just, so I don't really know how we got it wrong. Because we are blessed. We are blessed with capacities. What capacities is there? In fact, anywhere in the world, go to anywhere. If you are being outside the world, you see that Nigerians are great warriors. We are strugglers. We even do better outside the country, even than Nigeria. And why? Opportunities are there. Opportunities are provided. But when they are not provided for you, please create opportunity for yourself.
Thank you, sir.
Nigeria will be more... No, go. Nigeria will be the most populous country in the world by 2050. With addition of 189 million people, according to the United Nations Department of Economic and Social Affairs. Note that the land mass is not increasing anyway. What can the young engineers do to solve this problem? Next slide. Now, who has the solution? Who has the solution? If you say that we are problem solvers, then who has the solution? It is the engineers. And that is why failure is not in my own dictionary. If you block a way for me, I will make another way. Because there is no way you can block here not to pass. If you use the best AC in your car and you are passing through a dusty environment, bet with me, particles of dust will enter your car. There is no way you can see it. Go and bring any car, unless it is not this Nigerian dust. Because Nigerian dust, where you are even passing, you are not even passing through the dust, you are even dangling and dancing inside the dust because the road is even dangling. So there is no way. The vehicle, as it is dangling, will still go.
Definitely 1 minute.
Okay. Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, he has spoken for how many minutes? How do you see what he's saying with the basic background I gave to you? Just do the analysis. You understand? Thank you very much. You know, before you came, I gave them some analysis. I told them how to think inferentially. And I gave them basic mathematical tools, just like you are saying now. What was he saying now? A lot of challenges. But which one is more important than the other one? If you solve the most important, just one or two, solve energy problem in this country. Or if you don't say globally, solve infrastructural problem. Among those, solve energy problem. You know, I gave you, how we differentiate? How do we differentiate? Breakdown. But there are many things you can break down, but you use the most powerful one. Not so? You don't differentiate starting from your coefficient. You start from... Thank you very much.
Thank you, my prof. That means I want to count myself lucky today. I'm in the spirit. I was not here when my distinguished prof did his own presentation. But he is confirming that I am in the spirit, aligning with what he has said. That is mentor-mentee relationship. Thank you so much. Now, engineers generally possess commendable numerable abilities, such as being analytical. Yes, we are very, very analytical. Oh, if an engineer comes forward like this, he wants to talk, you analyze. But after the analysis, what solution is he preferring? Because you see some people, even some pastors, go to some pastors, they will pray for you, they will see the problems. But tell them to come and face the challenges, they will run away. well as the ability of assessing and measuring risk while providing mitigation measures. Forget that. But where do you stand as a young engineer? That is the area I'm going on. You have a choice. You have a choice to be creative or not to be. To be innovative or not to be. To be a future, an impacted future leader or not, you have a choice. You can join them to analyze the problems and point out the faults. Or you can choose to be different by finding the remedies to the problems. Some people will criticize, they will analyze. But tell them what is the way out. They won't, but they will continue to bring X plus Y equals to this. Well, they have nothing to offer. We have them more in this country. I don't want the young engineers to be like that. Like I've told you, the world is changing. I want us to change the world. It can start from here. It can start from 2018 conference. Please. That is why some of us believe in the review of the Nigerian Society of Engineers memos. Because it is outdated. If someone like me is still keen into the memos that was maybe amended before I was born, or the memos that was amended last when I was in the secondary school, then where is my future? Where is my future? That is why I would not say because I'm a National High School member, I just have to continue like that. No. And that is why I give it. I give it to the present president of the Nigerian Institute of Engineers, Engineer Adekunle Mokolu FNAC. He has been agitating for this even before he became the president, that it must be changed. But not everybody will go the same way. Not everybody. This is where you have two or three who are gathered in my name. The Bible says it. But in Nigeria, when we want to change it, where two or three are gathered to review a progressive document, you will see noise. You will see even they can even slap themselves. Look at what is happening at the National Assembly. Leave that one. As a young engineer, how creative are you? Do you always ask, what is my nation doing for me? Like some of you ask, what is NSC doing for me? What have I gained in NSC? If you here keep asking that, I'm very sure you'll not be here. Please, let us be part of those people that will change NSC. I think the question should be, what can I do for my nation? And the question should be, what can you do for your society? Look at me as I'm standing here before you. I was nobody. My father, my parents, they are stark illiterates. I'm not saying illiterates. Stark illiterates. Zero. No, my father don't know the meaning of thank you. My mother don't know the meaning of thank you. You go to say you are busy. Please permit me to welcome one of the National High School members, Engineer Mrs. Nena Chinyere Igwegbe. She's very industrial, she's very creative, she's very innovative. And we have in her bag, Peter, can you get me a seat here, please? This man come is one of my mentors, and he must not sit there. This is a past chairman of Port Harcourt branch. Who knows Bonny Island? Bonny in River State. This is one of the gurus of Bonny. He's our great guy, the oil man, engineer Clifford. You're welcome, sir. Yes. So what are we saying? They are stark illiterates. But what happened? And let me tell you, my father has no children. We are not many. We are just 24. We are not many. And you can imagine how 24 will come out. How one person will come out of a polygamy? At the end of the day, I sneaked myself into greatness, into success, by fire, by force. By fire, by force. My dear brothers and sisters, if you are praying, please put action. Don't pray alone. You can't be in the dark and say, man, I should come from above. At times, I don't even go to church. I preach it anywhere. But I pray to my God. I pray to my destiny. Going to church is not my problem. I can go. I can wear, because I love fashion. I can wear good clothes to church. Because it was hair. Hard to be in the boarding school. I decided that I would be doing boarding school. I always pray that we don't go on holiday. Why some students will be praying that they should go on holiday? God is my witness. I prefer not to go to all on holiday because it is hell. When I became, and the funniest thing is, I'm not the first, I'm not the second, but I'm saying it here today that I was the first to enter university in my family. And to those of you, no, none of you can even know, you know, we are not GSS 1, GSS 2. It's class 1, class 2, class 3, class 4, class 5. At class 3, this thing is going all over the world. Class 3, I got GC 4. At class 4, I passed. And I went to university. I didn't go to class 5. At the end of the day, problem persists. Because problem will even continue. Because it's when you are making waves that all those unwavy things will be pulling you down. But you have to be focused. And I said, I'm going to study a course that will be different. Because my father was a mechanic. That's why I studied mechanical engineering. At the end of the day, as God will have it, I had my second class upper division. I was even humiliated not to have the first class because it was very, very diplomatic and difficult there. Unlike now that you'll be producing 300 first class graduates. At the end of the day, I was posted to to Delta State. What happened? I became the overall parade commander in camp again. Which gave me automatic ticket to go and serve at Shell Petroleum. That was where my problems started reducing. Because I said, hey, me when I run away from house, you can't put me for Shell. 2 weeks on, 2 weeks off on the onshore. I said, no way. I don't go home again. But you see these people that they monitor you, like, you know, just be focused. So not to bother you with all these things. It started like that. I started struggling up to today. At 33, I became a member of the Osun State House of Assembly through hard work. And I became the youngest in the house, and I was given, because they say, engineers, they are not given rightful position. No, we are KMCs. Go and find out. I will fight for my own right position. Even right and left, I will fight for them. At 33, in the House of Assembly, I told them, and I became the chairman of Committee on Works and Transport. If you don't fight for your right, they will trample on it. That's what will happen. Because you're an engineer, so, Fashola an engineer. Engineers will be there, they'll be shouting, why engineers not make Minister of Works? When Fashola was struggling, where are you? You think politicians, they have 2 heads? You are in your house. Some of you don't even have PVC. You stay inside your house. When appointment come out, a guy there, you go start to sing, oh Jesus, hallelujah, eh? You go start. You think say that the case? Nigerian politicians are not crazy. We know what we are doing. If I become governor tomorrow, I'm telling you, I'm going to put people who work with me. People who suffered. If you like, make it be engineer, stay inside us. I'm not going to put you. Because even the Bible recognizes that you should help those people that help you. So please take note of that. I'm going to talk on that later. Now, look at this. The right mindset to have and possibly create an enlightened environment enhancing the lives of Nigerians. So now, this one now takes us to the real topic, creative entrepreneurship. As a young engineer, how creative are you? Do you always ask? Oh, no? Okay. Creative entrepreneurship is the practice of setting up a business. Which kind of business? It can be any business. You can go into any business that will be engineering related, that will be technological related, something that will just solve a problem. Now, people are delving into biomedical engineering. Yes. We didn't have this in the past. That means we are going to medicine. Now, I created an identity for myself, political engineering. I don't come to your house, come chop. I don't come to your house, come say I don't get money for school fees. People are still, they are not coming to me.
Please mentor me, sir.
Don't worry. So what I'm telling you today is, create an identity, let it be any business that will venture, into something great, that will make you something great. that we are not talking of stealing engineering. We are not talking of assassinating engineering. We are talking of a business that, in fact, by the time you come out, people will see you. That's why you see some engineers who go into banking. Though unemployment is part of the problem, at least technologically. But the thing is, the Nigerian engineers who are in banking industry today are the best bankers. I can quote me anywhere.
Yes,
they are the best bankers in Nigeria. How many? They are doing very well. Now, you need to set yourself up as self-employed, which I just said, in one of these creative industries, such as photography, bank. You see, I'm a master of ceremony. My voice is crushed, but I don't care. Some engineers, they are very shy, but they want to make it. Some engineers, they are somewhere, they want to make it. If you want to make it in this country, please, don't be shy. At times, you know what happened? 2003, 2007, when I was in the House of Assembly. When I'm not being, please, permit me to welcome one of your stakeholders from Mina Branch, and one of the aspirants, I mean candidates, into the House of Reps in Niger State, Engineer Mustafa Ibrahim. You're welcome, sir.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
You see this man? He's going for House of Reps. I'm going to House of Assembly. But let me tell you, I'm his mentor. He's my mentee.
That is very
you can imagine that. And he's going to House of Reps. That is it. Today, this is part of my own business now. You need to make people, please. Now, some people, when they invite them, come and do masters of ceremony, they will be shy. Or they will be big. Now, like, to those of you who were in Kano, who was in Kano for Nameki Conference, I was a master of ceremony for the whole program.
Yes,
my people were in London. I was supposed to go for World Engineering World Engineering Federation Engineering Congress. I didn't go because I wanted to be MC. I didn't collect one naira. Nothing. They did not pay me for anything. But because I wanted to serve. Because the service humanity, my motto is service to humanity, which is the best work of life. I went to Kano. Do you know what happened? At the end of the day, somebody helped me. And at the end of the day, the man said, I love you, you are too. He started speaking grammar. Yeah, I said, okay, I'm waiting beyond this grammar. The name I just noticed is he bought me 10 imported shoes. See my guy in the club where as he's sitting there, he has just brought Niger Delta clothes. He has not seen it, but he has said to me that I'm bringing Niger Delta clothes for you at the conference. He bought for me last month. I'm very sure he has bought again.
Thank you, sir.
That's another business. It's my guy, but that's another business. This year, no, I don't know how many things they have bought for me just because of creativity. Now, we have engineers who are into music engineering now. They are creating their world. I beg, wait till their video reach. Wait their video. Who will get money past their video here? Who will get money reach their video here? Ordinary music. The guy that make money, he wanted to use it one day. I thought it's something that.
mandate. That is important. Now, what is creativity and innovation in entrepreneurship? I am going to send this paper to your team leader. I want us to speak in this paper. God. So, you are going to send it to you. Please go to the next slide. Then, like I told you, some people are just talking, they don't communicate. Please, be a communicator. Don't be a talkative. Don't be a talkative. You talk like a parrot. You can see in Nigeria today, the pastor that made it more, and the one that said, oh my God, yes, I'm going to tell you today that Jesus Christ is here. Okay. If you see the pastor you see that people will be speaking. Now, please identify your passion. You need to identify your passion. Don't be focused on this. Know what you are feeling. Identify my own necessity. Identify my own qualities. If my quality is not a professional, it's just a passion.
God bless you, sir.
Because I've seen somebody be asked, what are you doing? He said, I'm a politician. Countries, you can't see somebody who is an illiterate riding a car because you have to pass through a lot of things. High test, after that one, you go for written test, 30 questions you must pass. Other 24 questions is CBT, computer based questions. When you pass, you go for road test. After that one, before you can be issued a driver's license. But in Nigeria, a dead man, they get the driver's license. Even a blind man, blind person, they get driver's license. I don't understand. Now, you have to reskill, please have a skill in your passion. Reskill yourself, create ways of imparting life, while making some money. So, make sure you enjoy what you are doing. As long as you enjoy what you are doing, you are good to go. Engineers are the only professionals that fit in any sector, like I've told you before. Our people in banking and other places, they are good to go. Go to the next slide. Yes, some of us can be policymakers to right the wrongs of others. Yes, that is why I told you, and I'm still going to say it, young engineer, please go into politics. Don't say please start from scratch. Start from your local level. Start from your ward. A politician who is not impactful in this our world. What? Local. He's not a politician. Yes, I'm proud of myself. As I'm here, you know, in Osun State today, they are taking over. Areko Shala is handing over to Oyetola today in Osun. And I'm here. I'm participating right there. As I'm talking to you, you can't see me posting anything today now. Because I'm here and I'm there. So I have to double standard this thing. But what am I saying? My people, I mobilized almost 2,000 from my base now to go to the capital. What are they to go and do? Do you think they want to go? Do you think it's because of the lady? Hello? Do you think it's because of the governor? It's because of myself. Because if you refuse to be recognized at your base, then you are finished. Because if anything happens, you are covered in your village. I can move anytime, any moment. Moment, occasion, home, in my village. Nothing will happen. That is it. Now, next slide. So please, go into politics. Yes. What I'm about to say are my findings about. They are my thoughts. Now, the young engineer should not be left alone. Fine. He or she needs a mentor and proper follow-up mechanism should be imbibed. Like my mama Irelu gave me a point. I'm not going to disclose it more. About how we can have a mentor-mentee relationship. That at least a mentor should a mentor should take care of at least 3 mentees in a year. And for what purpose?
Eh? For what purpose? It's for the benefit of their mentees, of those mentees. Because we have not been having all these things. And that is how our young engineers can grow. Then there should be a well-structured path for the young engineers to follow. Fine. Another one is make all industries, organizations, and stakeholders to support the equipping of testing laboratories in our institution. We all know that we have laboratories, but we don't have laboratories. We have laboratories in Nigeria, but we don't have laboratories. There is a difference between laboratories and laboratories. Equipped laboratories, they are the functioning ones. They are the standard ones. They are the modern age ones. They are the ones that you can go to hospital that you can be, at least, you can know what you are doing. That when you are even doing any construction, that you can be able to fit in. But other ones we have in this place, you know what is happening. Mm-hmm. Let's go and get about that one. Engineering curriculum should be properly reviewed. I put properly reviewed for a purpose. They are doing it. It's not that they are not doing our curriculum in this country. But the problem is, are they properly reviewed? You know, everything is corrupted in this country. Even if you go to a barber, carry your clipper, because the clipper is corrupt. Barber's clipper is corrupt. Please, carry your clipper when you are even going there. Or else, you just realize that you are using a corrupted clipper. So, those people who are even reviewing our curriculum, how often do they do it, one? And how competent are they? So, all these things need to be put into consideration. Go on. Now, AutoCAD. Gone are the days most of us are using, like I told you earlier on, our blackboard. Go carry them. We were even, in fact, that time you don't even make shakara with the blackboard. I'm ready to call himself. Blackboard. T-square. I don't forget the name now. What did they call her? Ah, my God. There was a day I saw Matset. Most of you don't even know the meaning of Matset here. I saw Matset. I said, yeah. If you get Matset in the olden days, your papa get money. Because you will go to, bookshops are functioning. Not now. That everything are Google. You go, if you go Google, you go Google, you go Google, you still go Google. But then, by the time you visit, you want to resume school, you'll be looking for the best bookshops. In fact, I was in Akure then. I will leave Akure, go to Ibadan, listen to me, publishers. I'll be looking for the best. In fact, you will be looking for the neatest textbooks. You will go down and go and pick the neatest one because you want to make shakara for school. You see? But nowadays, how many people are even reading? How many people are even reading now? So that is why the computer-aided design software is available. But we are of the opinion that this should be put into consideration from first year in the university. I could remember my first year to my fifth year as a mechanical engineer. I'm sorry to say, I didn't see computer. I went to go and learn computer. Ordinary person taught me about computer. Ordinary person. So it is good if all these things are good to help Sean out articulated graduates that are ready for the industry. That is why in overseas, if you want to get a job, they don't look for 15, 25, 25 years experience. Once you are taken, they'll send you for training. But in Nigeria, somebody who is even writing the paper, 15 years experience, how many years experience you don't get? Sir? He's looking for 15 years experience to come and get a job. That is why they are killing us in this country. And that is why young engineers need to be articulated. You need to plan your own way. Don't be too dependent. Now, who is blocking our... Okay. We are talking of internship and training. That's part of what we are talking about. We, Nigerian Institute of Engineers, we are agitating. We are advocating. And we believe one day that one will come to pass. It is not the fault of Nigerian Institute of Engineers. It is the fault of the system. Because how many industries and manufacturing companies are even doing well in this country today? And we are producing more graduates. So that is not the fault of NSC. Then we need to encourage research programs to meet industry needs. Management engineering should be introduced school curriculum from the onset. Engineering management is very, very important. Some of us, we are not best administrators. You can be employed as an administrator, you can be employed as a professional engineer. But it depends. What is important is wherever you find yourself, you must be able to be set, be ready. Be set, be ready. Again, we are talking of the social and welfare programs with some political encouragement. Compulsive. We have go. Strategies should be devised to encourage them to attend the activities of the Nigerian Institute of Engineers. In 1 minute, please encourage your colleagues. Let them come into the system. If you are not part of the system, you have no reason to complain. If you are not part of the system, you cannot be put apart. We started like this. If you are into this in the system, you can be. Let us, because either we like it or not, we are handing over to you people. So it is better we hand over. Like there are some people when they want to hand over, they don't see who to hand over to. Then everything will now collapse. Please make yourself available. Then leadership courses should be introduced in the school curriculum to prepare them for leadership. Expose them to international activities such as conference and competitions. If you want to Nigeria Institute of Engineers, you have ideas, you have a lot of innovations, you can create it that we can be able to move forward. Then that one can project you to international communities. Then we have next slide. Then I said, these are many more I believe can turn our wonderful youths and growing nation to amazing people and a nation. Now let us face facts. Nothing is possible in this country, in this world. Please dare to dream and come up with great ideas. Rather fail at doing something than succeed at doing nothing. Be audacious. Have the courage to take calculated risks. Be hungry for success. Don't settle for mediocrity. Some people believe when they fail, that's the end of life. No. Failure can lead you to success, depending on how focused you are. The truth is that you face pressure. If you want to be big, if you want to make it in life, you must be ready to face pressure. Please, don't say because you are going and you meet pressure and you don't want to backslide. Keep going, keep pushing, you'll get there. But if you fail under pressure, you are a poor specimen. The issue is not the problem. Rather, the problem is how much you can be able to handle the problem. Leave your comfort zone. Yes, some people are still mother's pets, daddy's pets. They say daddy's pet, he or she will be happy. I'm not going to talk. You better leave your comfort zone. Like some of us did, that we became Osale runaway. Today, the story, the others are story. Please, leave your comfort zone. Stop sleeping with mommy. Some of you are still sleeping with mommy in the bedroom. Get away from your parents' paper streams. You can afford to fail many times when you are just starting. You have the time to learn from your mistakes and to correct them. Now, many people are looking for money, till they will die. They will still be looking for money. Please stop that. Stop looking for money or make a name. That's why I said initially that you have to create an identity for yourself. Please make a name. These people who are talking about them, they are making their names. It is when you make a name that big money, plenty money will come your way. So, you can go to the next slide. Then you have to touch that. Then, are you ready to make an impact? Then begin to look for problems to solve if you are ready to make your part. Because if you do things professional way, somebody has done it before. If you want to do that thing somebody has done before, please update it. Don't do it the same way. Make something different so that people will know that, oh, you did it. Wherever you find yourself, there will be problems to solve. Don't run from problems. Problems are the food of champions. The more the problems you solve, the higher you go. And every problem you solve comes with associated. There is no way to solve problem that you will not get it and you get away out of it. Then, like I told you earlier, I followed my passion and today I found my dream. I followed my passion and found my dream. Something came up about 30 minutes before I walked into this hall. I was sent a powerful message from my household. I'm a prince. I'm a royal prince. But one thing is very important today now when they are talking. In the royal family, That message has a meaning. 26th December, a family meeting, royal family meeting. And I looked at myself when the message came here. I said, hey, now wow. The boy don't go up. A whole compound that will have about princes and princesses of about 200. They want to find out my movement for December to fix a date for a meeting. I would have been a king in 1997, but my father refused. He said I should still continue. The king of my village is my age mate. He's my first cousin. If you see him, you know, yeah, look alike. So, but we're supporting him. But one day I know every prince is a potential king. I dream to be a king one day. So leave that. You have to do something. You have to change your mind. All these things you are talking about, before they can be achievable, you have to change your mindset. Some people have wrong mindset. They are Thomas. They don't even believe anything. And you want to make it. Some people will be praying, God, I want to make it. When they want to make it, they will say, you're the craze. And if they tell the king, when one make you, the craze. You think you're craze, go now. Why don't you imbibe the opportunity and just grab it? Grab your copy now. And success will just come your way. Now, there's another thing. If you want to start from now, please start. Start from now. There's a manifesto tonight. To those of us who are contesting,
when you have your mentors on the top table, you feel so good and so confident. And I say, thank you so much to the organizer program. I want to say again that as long as we keep trying hard to make the Nigerian Center of Engineers great and greater, I shall fund them. That's great. Thank you so much.
Yes, you people don't understand. His royal roofness is immeasurable. That English is beyond your league. You don't know what I'm saying. Yes, we've heard about what it is to hear, another is to do. Who is ready to do here? Okay, you see that my usual song? Someone hears, they cannot hear. Some can hear, yes, and we have heard, so we will use it well. So let's let the rest of us get our score. I'm proud to be here myself. I told you before, it's all about me. My team has spoken, my father has spoken, my uncle has spoken. But you see, everybody on this table, once upon a time, I have had the time, I have had the chance to look up to them. But now, it's not for you. Like I always tell my people, everybody is good to listen to. There is not everybody that is good to follow. True or false. But I can bet my life, people you are seeing here are people you should follow, hold their head and follow properly. And you get to the next level. So before we go to the next lecture, I'm a well-brought up child. I give no more to those that deserve it. See, listen, respect. You don't fight for respect, you earn respect. The people here, you can see when they were coming, the way I was excited to talk about them, that shows they have earned it. It's not because I'm afraid of them, although that's part of it. So, ladies and gentlemen, Let's go to our past vice president three times. No closer, I want to student the environment. I'm in Nigeria, a proud one. Okay, you have to join us in this song. We make Nigeria a good nation. I said we'll be making a great song. Not only me. I should ask you. Come on, we should ask you. Wait. I am going somewhere. I know we are doing something. But notice you, some of you can't even speak good English. And we are laughing at somebody long time ago. In my school days, we will say, excuse me, senior. A senior sent me a message. What is wrong with that English? I am coming to my mommy. She must give us a word before we do this lecture. So, a word from you can make the difference.
My elder here, Yes,
They say a word is a noun for. So are we wise? Am I wise? We've heard a lot today. We've shouted. Some people, they talk loud but say nothing. We were told. Some of us, we are very active, busy working, achieving nothing. It's not an attribute. It is the way of life of some people. Like I was telling you yesterday, I have a title. I am the man with the mechanical advantage. I earned that title because where I work, I am the only mechanical engineer in the mechanical engineering department of Omar Bello University. I did not say it's a lie. Wait till I become a backbone in MSc before you will clap for me. You see, I'm happy to be with you, I'm happy to be here, I'm happy to be talking with you, but I'm happier when, by this time next year, what we've heard today will translate into something. It's good enough to hear. You know, when we're growing up, if you misbehave, they don't talk to you, they'll say, whose son are you? You are indirectly telling them that you are not well put up. There is something your father. We can make the difference. So the next presenter is going to talk to us, and I am very sure we have our they gave us daughters that was supposed to write. I'm going to mark your faces because I'll download the video on YouTube. I'm going to mark your faces. And I'm going to also look at the future. I'll keep it for the future to wait, so that I will say, I know this man, or I know that man. But again, let's be, behind the who is rich. Sir, before we go to the next lecture, just give us a word or two, because the next lecture, we're trying to allow them to digest what they heard. So you actually then go for another lecture. Yes, sir.
Thank you very much. I'm glad to be with you guys. Honestly speaking, it's a privilege to see myself here, just like our Super VP. I don't know if any of you have ever seen her play the role in Super Smash. You know, most of you have said that. When she's a super engineer, in the sense that she's almost a rare, she's an actor, a great engineer, and at the same time, a great mentor. He was mentored by her, fully he mentored me. Honestly speaking, presently I'm a candidate of Abundant Nigeria Renewal Party. My presidential candidate is Tope Kolade Fashua. I met Kolade Fashua virtually. It's like we've been talking on daily talks even before the advent of social media struggling. We've been friends. One of the studies said, look, engineer, can't we do something about this country? We said, yes. I said, okay, this has something. Oh, you know it. A party was born in 2016. Believe you me, I've never worked for women before. I've been a private engineer all my life. I started from a school where I attended the Federal University of Technology here. If there is anybody from Nigeria, can you say hi? Thank you so much. Fact being that we have grown to become something outside the university. I will recall in the last 2 weeks or so, World Bank made a clarification that the Federal University of Technology, MENA, is one of the greatest centers of learning in Nigeria. You can go with you right there. Well, I realize that there are so many things we are missing, and this is the starting point. I just want to inform you or advise you, as my two mentors said, we must start very early. I got my first company registered in 2008. I finished 2001 and 2002 in Ghana. I served 2002 at the Ministry of Works and Housing in Abuja. You understand? After serving posts around, you know, I was mentored. I knew the work. I'm a civil structural engineer. I knew exactly what to do. I got my company registered in 2008. That's a consulting and contracting company. and I got a consulting company registered in 2012. I asked myself that I want to start managing money at the age of 40. I'm not managing money now, but I'm managing my company. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. There are two types of managers. The one that manage the little they have, and the one that manage business. The one is stingy, the other one is clairvoyant. Is it too hard to understand? So which one do you want to belong? The one that have companies. But I always like to have this question. How much is enough money? No answer. So well, our mommy would like to take a leave, so let's put a round of applause for her as she takes a leave. So let's keep clapping as she steps up. It is not easy. Sorry, I'm sorry, sir. Okay, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Keep clapping. Thank you, sir. So keep talking as we go. Thank you very much. Thank you. So, ladies and gentlemen, let's go to our next lecture. The lecture you are about to receive now. I am our guest lecturer for a very long time. He told me something long ago. Some years ago, he said I should contract as the chairman of Society of Nigerian Branch. That I can do it. He saw it in me that I can do it. But I refused. Then I was the publicity secretary. Some years later, not some years later, 2 years later, I looked at it and said, Oga believed in me. I am not believing in myself. That means there's something wrong somewhere. I have to recheck myself and believe in myself. And I'll be honest to you, I learned from him and learned from others.
Sorry, just a quick one. For those of us that have not joined any group, we have 5 groups. I think maybe you can extend it to 8 so that at least they can have that group. Thank you very much.
Thank you. We will do the grouping when we finish. If you stay to the end, you will do it. Because if one of us, because I've seen people, they started going, so I won't do the grouping now. You have to be part of us complete. So as I was saying, I became the chairman, and things worked out with the support and other support, and I saw that it was easy. So it will be easy if you listen to your gas. I always like using the word gas because Pidgin English is one of our first here, true or false? Because they said he doesn't speak good English. Is it true?
Yeah.
Because when you check the vital statistics of what we can evaluate, reasoning from the other side of our medulla oblongata, we realize that we can articulate what we need to achieve in order to promote ourselves to the next level. Is that not English? People are too serious here. Serious people are in the hospital. They will say the case is serious. So ladies and gentlemen, let's put our hands together for Jerry Day as he gives us his talk. Now this thing is going to be interactive. So I'm going to hold the mic and be among you. So if you don't want to talk, you'll be forced to talk. Thank you.
Thank you, good afternoon. I am a mechanical engineer with National Automotive Design and Development Council. The council has 2 major mandates. One, to regulate the automobile industry, and second is to make a Nigerian car available. Before I go into my paper, although it's informal because I'll just talk about this
know, I tried to speak on something. I'm not going to have a formal discussion with you. It's going to be informal. So, like you said, it's going to be interactive. But before I go into discussing my paper, it is important I say one thing about almost everybody on the high table. Fortunately, it appears serious-minded people are coming together. Let me start with Professor S.S. Adefila. I got into Awadu Bello University in 1987. That is Faculty of Engineering. I got into JBU in 1985 for my A levels, but I got into Faculty of Engineering in 1987. At that time, Professor Adefila was a very senior man. The first approaching we can. But since I knew him till date, one thing stuck in my head. And that is, you know, before 87 or before mid 80s, Nigeria, our economy witnessed what was known as the oil boom. From 87 or mid 87 till now, is what is known as the oil doom. And one of the problems we have had as a nation is that we have not managed the oil doom very well. Professor Adefila stood out for me as a lecturer because at the time when the structural adjustment program was introduced, lecturers were complaining about pay. But then, those of us that came into Faculty of Engineering knew him as the rich lecturer. Why? He stood out among the many lecturers. Maybe some will have copied him now. He had a manufacturing company since that time. So he wasn't, he had a lot more income than the school was paying him. That's in addition into going to poultry farming. So whenever I see him, that's the first thing that registers in my mind up to today. That's Professor Adefila. For our former VP, Engineer Manuel of Kala, I sat under her as chairman of membership or something. One thing I picked up from her leadership was that she was focused. She's not distracted. She managed the affairs of that committee very well, and she was extremely time conscious. Whenever anybody wants to digress, she's always bringing it back to the subject matter. But more important than that is that engineers, you should place value on yourself. And how do you place value on yourself? Don't go begging. It's one thing that even the national body has done so badly. But I've seen it in a few people. I believe in it. Don't beg. Try to have something you can sell. When she was CPC chairman, was it 2-3 years back? They went to companies, but they want something to sell to the company, not to just go to the company and ask for money, run like that. You must have something that you can offer for sale. So it's one of my attractions to her that she didn't give us an image of a begging engineer. And I expect that all of you here will have that in mind from this way, from this day forward, that you will not beg. Now, for the education you have been given, you must think of something that you can sell. As Kilomodemo, the first attraction to him was that from nowhere, he brought out Osogbo brand to prominence. chairman that Oshogbo branch took first position in group dynamics. I don't know whether you're familiar with group dynamics. That's the rating of activities of branches. And here, again, I have seen him as a very dynamic person. He's a goal getter. I have seen the way he operates. As for Engineer Chinyere, even though I've known him for a very long time, it's just about 2 years now that we started working closely together. And I noticed that she's committed to what she does. It's like she sets out a timetable for her and she will start ticking them one by one. She's very serious and extremely time conscious. I believe I'm not so familiar with the last person on the high table, but I believe it's because likes attract that is also part of this. He must also be a very nice person. So to my discussion with you, the who has done the title of the conference?
Sustainability. Who wants to be at this? What is that?
let me put it this way, gift and giving. United Kingdom, is it a developed economy or a developed economy? It's a developed economy. What about Nigeria? So what is the difference between the United Kingdom and Nigeria? I don't know.
That's the best of their market value, you know.
Developing countries, for instance, some they have ability to produce some, they are still dependent on other nations, just the way we have in Nigeria.
Yes, please.
Okay, a developed economy is the one which with resources meets the demand. Why the developing economy is the one which resources is below?
Yes. Perhaps you'll be able to find a role for yourself. The difference between a developed economy and a developing economy is basically engineering. Is basically, if from a layman's perspective, the difference between United Kingdom and Nigeria is that they've been able to manage their engineering very well. The basic difference is just technology between all these countries. Okay? So, but that's to put it mildly. If you look at Nigeria from independence till date, how will you rate our infrastructural development? Poor, fear, good, excellent. Fear? It's poor. And why is it poor? The number one comment is that our planning is very poor. Our planning is very poor. In the early 60s, 70s, maybe part of early 80s, they were begging people to talk. But what we have today, from 10, 20 years to this time, what do we have? All of you here are employed. Planning has been poor. And one very clear part of that is that population is growing. Nothing is done to take care of the growth in population. Another one is adequate policies. We do, although people say we have policies, implementation is lacking, but that is not true. We don't have policies. As a matter of fact, in my own auto industry, President Jonathan just signed the auto industry bill before he left, because we didn't have an auto policy that assembly plants from outside will hold us with. If you had had any dealing with anybody, there should be a document, all right, and how you want to go about it. Like I told you, I'm also a student of energy studies. There is no energy policy. Go and find out. Go and Google. Go to energy policy. I mean, the energy commission. And find out if Nigeria has energy policy. Another thing that has caused this problem for us is instability in governance. Of our 60 years of independence, 58? Is it? That's 58, isn't it? The military has ruled for how long? For at least half of that first time, is it? More than half. It could work for us, but unfortunately, it didn't. Because the human being is selfish. It could have worked for us, but because of the selfish nature of human being, it didn't work for us. And that is why democracy is very, very important. That you should have a say in your affairs. Thank God for democracy. As long as we have democracy in place, we'll have the opportunity to be changing leaders based on their performance, provided we don't scuttle it. There's also the issue of poor physical planning. Poor physical planning. And I want all of us to take note of that. All across the country now, including Abuja, how many of these cities is planned? How many of these cities will be planned? How many? And do you know what we mean by planning? Or let me simply put it this way. Abuja is planned. Some part of Lagos is planned. But Abuja is planned, and at some point, the plan was distorted until everybody came to begin to readjust the plan.